when the students and I spoke about what we were trying to deliver with this bench and where it would be, we had in mind that it would come to here, to Pioneer Park. We knew that we wanted to deliver those conversations, that we wanted people to sit on this bench and share memories, someone being able to say, I used to use that particular tool, or being able to recognise it, because not all the things here are easily recognisable in the modern age. But someone being able to say, I had one of those, we used to use it for this, is a point of being able to move into a conversation about the past and the present. And that's something that benches are about too, about delivering the past in the present. The thing about a bench, for me, is that it's a place where two people sit, two or more. So immediately it opens the opportunity for dialogue. And I think dialogue is one of the most important things that we can have with one another. Something about a bench is we look out away from it. I mean, we look over whatever is in front of us. And it takes that direct face-to-face away. It makes it a little bit more contemplative. I think there was the opportunity for two people who knew each other to sit on these benches and enter into conversations that perhaps they hadn't entered into before. And again, being there are little engaging points throughout this that will bring forth that history, that living history that people have, and share it. So, yeah, ultimately, the perfect opportunity to enter into dialogue is a bench. Look, there's been a argument between form and function in furniture making ever since I first came across the processes. Function is entirely about how something functions in our day-to-day life. It is almost non-caring for the aesthetic. And then if we were to look at extreme form, then it's all about the form and completely renders everything often dysfunctional. So to make a chair, for example, that's 12 feet high would be absolutely pointless. And yet that could be a very beautiful form. And in fact, it's something I find rather attractive, perhaps not useless to a tennis umpire. So there's this constant argument between form and function. I personally carve a lot of spoons, and I'm more fascinated by where the shape is going. Could the handle come up here and then drop down, and how would that make me feel? And then someone may pick up that spoon and go to use it and go, this is completely useless. Yes, it can hold something, but it's just so crooked and, dysfunctional that it's pointless. And that's where the argument comes in, is how do you make something truly beautiful and also functional? Now, that's something that we've done forever. We've had some beautiful periods in our history, in the making history, where there is absolute beauty and functionality come together. And it's the challenge of every maker that works in the area of trying to make functional items. We are trying to make the functional beautiful, and therefore the form beautiful. Yeah, look, there are lots of items with this that were particularly interesting. The spanners I find really interesting, because I personally don't have a lot of knowledge of what they were used for, but they were coming from different directions. Some donated from a group of items, others from students who would literally say, this was my grandpop's and can we put that in, etc. Yeah, it was... So there's these little items that I really appreciate, but I'm not entirely even sure what they do. And there's some really obviously handmade ones, going back to being, out of necessity. Some of these have obviously been made on farms, etc., to be used for the job in front of you. Look, it certainly does reframe the items, doesn't it? And it brings together those periods of time. Yeah, look, it's an interesting aspect of museums, is that we're looking back at the past, and this is a certainly very different way of doing it. We're not looking at something inside a cabinet that's out of our reach. We're quite literally in contact with it, and we're in contact with it in a way it's never been in contact with before. It's left its world of functionality, and interestingly enough, it's fallen to form. It's become a whole nother creature. All these items have become other creatures. They've become part of something else. And I really like the idea that that it brings forth the conversations of the past in the now. It's informative, but it's physically informative too. It's made real. And I think that when you look at Pioneer Park and you look at these benches and you look at Action Day and everything that this museum that holds, it's making our past real. It's no longer something that is just in books or words. It's actually a very physical and active reality.